about to resume. The Blackhawks and the Maple Leafs meet for the eighth time. The Leafs won five of those series, the most recent in 1986, a 3-0 sweep. But the way these two closed out the season, everything this time points to a long, tough series. Good evening, everybody, from the broadcast booth in Maple Leaf Gardens. Starting for Chicago, Chelios, Suter, Brent Sutter, Graham, and Connie Worthen for the Leafs. Gill and Ellett, the defenseman. Eastwood, McRae, and Manderville, the forward line. Well, we're underway. 1994. The Chicago Blackhawks starting out is Suter. His pass is stray down the ice. Ellett back to pick it up. And boy, is this crowd at Maple Leaf Gardens into it early. Checking is Pearson. Couldn't get a shot though. Rick Sutter took it away from him. Played up on the boards, and there's Clark. The captain got it back. Low shot, rebound. And the Blackhawks were on it quickly and got it out of there. Aaron Aum will come back in his own zone. Here you go. Clark's long shot. Wendell Clark gets the first one. A deflection. And the Leafs say we'll take it. They're up 1-0.
Well, when you're going to shoot the puck in against Chicago, you might as well shoot it at Crawford, because he goes and gets most of them. Couldn't find a handle. Maybe if Balfour was back at the top of the crease, he'd add a split second longer to try and...
2:33, the time of the first goal. Marinov gets the assist. Clark took it near his own line, through center, ripped a hard shot. It was deflected, and Balfour couldn't make the move. 1-0, Toronto. To the line is Zezel. He's bumped by Kimball. Ellett couldn't keep it in. The Hawks jump on it. This is Schatz. His shot missed on the short side. Zezel in his own zone made the big circle. Now he's out to center. And it goes to Osborne, and just as quickly off his stick. Great pace to start this game. Bergen with a hit on Chelios. He'll be a target for the Leafs. Murphy coming in. McCown without a stick. Shot in at the net and blocked. And Lefebvre will bring it out. The lead pass intended for Borshevsky. In behind him. Cleared again to Zezel. He can't get it out. Amonte played it on the boards. It's centered. A puck by a big stop on Roenick. Good quick shot by Jeremy Roenick. Here's Chelios. Now Murphy. Chelios shot. Deflected wide of the net. And Zezel gets a stick on it, but it's still in there. Again, Zezel this time. He clears it down the ice by Gary Suter. Here's Gilmore. Back to the net. Clark out for Mironov. Broken stick. Loose puck. Gilmore got the loose puck behind Balfour. And it's 2-0 Toronto.
Well, the ability to retrieve loose pucks in the offensive zone is as important to a power play as being able to pass it or shoot it. And here's what the Leafs do. Look how far back four Chicago players are. All inside the hash mark. Mironov shoots a changeup. The stick goes wide of the net. The puck comes to Gilmore and he puts it in. The Hawks are a very aggressive penalty-killing crew. And you get burned sometime because you've got too few players on the periphery of the power play. And Anderchuk won't get an assist, but should. He bothered Balfour and tied the defenseman.
So Gilmore scores the power play goal for Toronto to make it 2-0. The Leafs with an early lead. And Chelios picked it up. He got it through center to Rutu, upended. Now he's coming up Gilmore. Puck by had to make that stop. a power play. Boy, the Leafs are checking fiercely now. It gets out over the line, and the Leafs make sure by bringing it over center. And it goes to Rouse and Vanderbilt. She scores! Vanderbilt gets the goal. And Toronto jumps out 3-0 on that short-handed goal by Ken Vanderbilt.
Well, a careless pass in the lead zone when the Hawks were on the power play that was deflected outside the blue line. They're up 3-0.
Clark, Gilmore, and now Vanderbilt. All kinds of goals. Even strength by Clark. Power play by Gilmore. Short-handed by Vanderbilt. 3-0 Toronto. By Isobart on the boards, and the two players go to the ice. Suter went in there, trying to hold Bill Berg at bay. But it says all back. Zezel won it smartly into the corner, giving the Leafs a chance to move it out. Suter moved up there, and Berg beat him to it. So the puck is between the two blue lines. As the horn goes to end the first period, with the Leafs out shooting Chicago 9-5. Clark, Gilmore, and Vanderbilt scoring for the Leafs.
16 years since the Toronto Maple Leafs opened the Stanley Cup playoffs at home. That was 78. They beat LA in the first round. They beat the Islanders in the second round. Perhaps the most exciting playoff save for last year in the last quarter century.
And that was on a Detroit power play. Thank you, Ron. The second period just underway here in Toronto with the Leafs leading 3-0. Clark missed it. Chicago trying to get it out. Rouse will stop it and get a shot right in front. Pearson couldn't handle it. He had a big open side. Here's Pearson again. Right in. And Belfour made a big save. Kick back to McCown. Scores! 4-0 Toronto. McCown shot, and that too, I believe, was deflected in front of Belfour. So he is having a tough time in goal for Chicago. 4-0.
Well, you can't blame the goalies on deflections. Zezel wins the draw. It's kicked to McCown, and he shoots it. Now two Hawks are on the Leaf forward in front. Peter Zezel. The center stayed with him. Suter goes to him. I don't know who it hit, but it definitely hit somebody before it went in.
And number 25, Peter Zezel. Time 3:35.
3:35, the time of the goal, and McCown gets it from Berg and Zezel. Berg there to stop the puck. And offside is called, and now Berg is decked by Dirk Brehm, and that will draw a crowd as Berg started it by throwing one hit, and then the moment he played the puck, he was hit. And look at this now. Wouldn't take much. Remember now, they played last Tuesday here. The Blackhawks won. Thursday in Chicago, the Leafs won. Some bad blood developed, and here we are in the quarterfinals of the Western Conference, the Leafs leading 4-0.
Well, Berg threw the first hit, but Dirk Brehm came in and really rattled every bone in Bill Berg's body.
Murphy gets the pass, but is in behind the net. Now he sent it to Chelios. Big save by Papin. Another test right here. Murphy going in. Papin's got it. Loose puck cleared off the stick of Suter. And out to center. Papin for the first time of the game. Getting tested here in the second period. And it's cleared out over the line. And here's Gilmore again backing up with it. Now he rolled it ahead. Andrew Chuck went to Gilmore. One man back. Gilmore in. Fake the shot. And can't get the shot on the net. A penalty coming up against the Chicago Blackhawks. Gilmore is roughed up again at center ice. A Gretchen was way down the ice. Stop as he called the penalty. We know there is one. Marinov put it off the boards back to Gilmore near the point. Gil is there with him. Here's Gil's shot. Rebound! Chuck couldn't stop it in. It's centered again.
5. Dave Andrechuk from Dmitry Mironov and Doug Gilmore. Time 6:25.
Second power play of the goal for the Maple Leafs. Andrechuk's first of the playoffs from Mironov and Gilmore at 6:25. Crashing, and then 10 seconds later, roughing. So he has 1:15 remaining. Clark coming in there. Centered it. Mironov shot deflected high. Mironov again with Gardner and in the corner, Pearson. Back to Mironov. He had to move quickly at the blue line and the Blackhawks intercept and get it out to Murphy. And Mironov got back to ride him into the boards. And Mironov is hit and hurt. The Leafs got up to center ice and Mironov, after taking the Blackhawk player in on the boards, was dumped heavily and here he is in pain.
He was speared by Joe Murphy right in the groin. Now I don't know that the referee saw it, but you can bet the linesman did. He's going to get
play. McCown against Rick Sutter. Got by him. Mironov on the ice again with Clark coming in. Clark going for the net. Got in there. Here's a shot. Now Bora had that one go off his shoulder and high as Gardner thought he had the opening. To the corner it goes. Borshevsky got it back. Mironov poked it ahead to Gilmore. Three of them are at the line. Gilmore near the boards. Waits. Mironov shot it. Hit a stick. Check stick and then just floated into Belfour and he got down on it with 1:42 remaining and a major penalty against Murphy of Chicago. But it's the Leafs leading 5-0. Kearney shot, hot pass, stick save. And that one slices high into the crowd and only 9 seconds left in the Chicago penalty. McCown takes a quick look, puts it right on it. The Leafs penalty against Rouse. He's off for hooking. Gardner moving up as far as the Hawks' blue line. Back in his chance, dropped it, and the shot doesn't get through. And Clark is away. Ian Gardner catching up is McCown. To McCown, back to Gardner. Belfour stopped the deflection.
Occurred. Now here's the race. You see Belfour coming here and he just wants to run a little interference on Clark.
one ahead, and out over the line it goes, and Chelios backs it up in his own zone. 25 seconds left of the period. Toronto leading 5-0. Gary Suter, a pass ahead to Brent Sutter, out of his reach. Toronto moving it back out and up to Zezel. Put one in there for Berg, but Belfort took it off the boards and cleared it back into the corner. Here's Zezel back in the net, centered it. Oh, Belfort had to go down quickly to smother that one. Oh! Just reached out the left mitt and nailed him.
Belfour, 61 penalty minutes as the goalie to set a Hawk record for goalies. He's obviously very frustrated. Zezel goes through the crease. He's not going to do anything. And Belfour gives him a shot. So Belfour's going to get a penalty. I don't know whether Peter Zezel will.
Not out of this period yet. 3.6 seconds left.
The Hawks have started to be belligerent. 5 goals too late. And Belfour takes another needless penalty.
Belfour for roughing at 1956. Toronto has 2 power play goals in this hockey game, and they'll come on in the third period with another opportunity on a power play.
For roughing, time 1956.
At 7:30 Eastern Time. And we'll be here with these same two teams, of course, in a best of seven series. Just over 3 seconds left in the period. Zezel trying to win that faceoff one more time. But it's Chicago holding the puck on the horn to end the second period. And the Leafs add 2 more to a 3-0 first period lead. And lead 5-0.
Well, Eddie Belfour's got to get himself under control, or he's going to end up causing his team more trouble than they already have. The Leafs, 20 minutes away from making a 1-0. And Bob, April 8th, 87, 4 overtimes in Washington. LaFontaine took us out of our misery, you remember?
Sure. And the Blackhawks know have to get going. Along with this one, Chelios. Hot man made a big save there on a deflection. Eyes of Arn on the boards. They try to go back to Chelios, and here he is again. With Graham. Chelios once more. Winds up for the shot. He's stopped, though, by Gilmore, who's without the stick. But he just parked himself right in front of him. Other side now, and back to Chelios again. Gilmore standing there, daring him to shoot. Here's Chelios. He scores! Finally, a whistle by Gilmore and everybody else. And into the net. And the Blackhawks finally on the board on a power play here in the third.
Well, not on.
Marinoff flipped it in there. And it stopped at the side of the net. In on the board. Now center. Whistle one just wide. Played back out. Brent Sutter gets it up to center and over the line. Graham takes it, feeds it ahead, and Graham missed it as it came through his skates.
Yes,
so winning goaltender.
The Conn Smythe Trophy's been presented 39 times. Goalies have won it 10.
That is Gartner coming in to pierce it. He missed. Gartner tried to knock it in behind the goaltender, who was out and couldn't get much on it, but now he stops the tearing pass. Here's Gartner working his way from the corner out front to Clark. He was bumped enough to the ice. Caught by Weinrich. Clark was slow getting up. And a penalty being called now. Suter to the left side and back to Suter. Quick shot. Hoffman got the pad on it. But a bounce behind him. Nearly got him. Suter again. Crank one up. This time it's blocked by Zezel and comes to center. McCown and Andrzejczyk, and another power play goal for the Leafs in the second. And then Chelios on a Chicago power play here in the third. 10 seconds remaining. Rick Center dumped it off the boards behind the net, but the crowd is cheering. This one down to nothing.
blue line. Even 28-28, the shot total after three periods. But the score, the Maple Leafs 5 and the Blackhawks 1. I think they'll break them up and convince them that this, in fact, Harry, is done.
Save your energy till Wednesday. Both teams will need it. The Leafs were superior tonight. It gives them a start. But the Hawks have got lots of heart and lots of grit. And any doubt whether Potvin couldn't get his game in shape for the playoffs should be removed the way he played tonight. He wasn't busy for two periods, but he looked like the old Potvin to me in the third.
So the Leafs won the first game, 5-1, and here's Ron McLean.
Thank you, Bob. During the year, Toronto had 4 20-goal scorers. The Hawks had 2, and offense seemed to be the edge for the Leafs as they got rolling early. There are the Molson 3 stars this evening. Kent Manderville's goal was the third of the game.